Now, with a little more than 6 weeks before Election Day, a new poll out this week shows Missouri Republican United States Senate candidate Todd Akin with a 4-point lead over Democratic incumbent Claire McCaskill. The Gravis firm phoned close to 2,000 likely voters and has a margin of error of 2.3%. By the way, in the race for president, the poll shows Republican Mitt Romney firmly in control of the Missouri vote. The survey has Romney leading President Barack Obama in Missouri, 48% to 39%. Now, there have been polls that have put McCaskill ahead since the primary. So how valid is this latest poll, Dave Helling?
I don't think it completely accurately reflects the state of the race in Missouri on both the Senate level, frankly, Nick, and the presidential level. Most polls have Mitt Romney +6, +7 in Missouri. This one has him +9. So I think you could probably shave 2 or 3 points off the Republican finding for both the presidential and the Senate race, which suggests, which I think is accurate, that Akin McCaskill is fairly close, 1 or 2 points, one way or the other. Margin of error stuff. That shouldn't be a surprise. Before the controversial comments about quote-unquote legitimate rape, I think everyone expected Todd Akin to win relatively easily in the state of Missouri, given the winds and the way the state is playing out politically. Now I think it's a toss-up, and that's,
shouldn't,
I think, where we
shouldn't
are.
Shouldn't be a surprise. I think most people were thinking there was no way whatsoever that Todd Akin could recover, Mary, those remarks.
Initially, but I mean, in the fact that he just became so toxic, everyone from the Republican Party just ran from him, the issue of the funding, his money was cut. However, no one knows what you do when you go into that voting booth. And people, you know, are still going to vote where their mindsets already were. And in the state of Missouri, it is very strongly Republican. It's a little scary, though, when you look at some of the things that are coming out now, like this week when they had the event in St. Louis and Phyllis Schlafly standing up there. I mean, a woman who just went on and on and on, made her whole lifestyle about being opposed to the ERA. That's who's standing up for him now. But the problem is, once people get in the voting booth, I think the issue of the U.S. Senate being in play, that's going to press a lot of people, and they will vote
but
for him.
But she's not the only one. You have Newt Gingrich is coming into town, I think, that next week to be stumping for Todd Akin.
I think the key thing you take away from any of these polls, whether it's the Gravis poll or Rasmussen, who a week ago had Claire up by 6 points, is there's anywhere from 10 to 16% undecided, and that's where this race is going to be decided. Anyone who thought when Akin stepped on his own feet about a month and a half ago that this race wouldn't eventually tighten wasn't paying attention to politics in Missouri. And I think after the deadline of September 25th, when he's on the ballot for good, Akin, you're going to see Republican money start to come back into this state. You're going to see Crossroads and Freedom Works and everyone else come in and start funding his campaign again, because the Senate is in balance. And if this race stays tight, money will come back and Akin will win the race.
Well, I agree that the money will come back. And he was, as Mary said, toxic at first. But to suggest that if you thought Todd Akin didn't stand a chance early on, that you weren't paying attention to politics, that means a lot of very well-connected former politicians and current politicians weren't paying attention then. Because there was a slew of prominent Missouri Republicans who said, get out. You cannot win. Some of the best-named Republicans in this state said that Todd Akin simply cannot win. But what I think this speaks to, these polls, and I don't put a lot of stock in this Gravis poll. None of us had even heard of it prior to this week. But what I think this speaks to is how unpopular Claire McCaskill truly is in the state of Missouri. Not that Todd Akin is popular, but that she is incredibly unpopular in many segments.
Yeah, I disagree a little bit with my colleagues about Republican money coming back in for Todd Akin after the 25th. I actually had a chance to talk with Karl Rove at the Democratic National Convention of all places. We were stuck on an elevator together. And his concern and opposition to Todd Akin is pretty firm. And I think he'll believe, and other sort of third parties will believe, that if they go back on their word and fund Todd Akin, that will become an issue in other states. People will say, hey, you're not opposed to Todd Akin anymore. And it will also suggest that his threats and other threats like them don't stick. What I do think could happen, Nick, is that there will be other anonymous third parties come in on Todd Akin's behalf. Social welfare organizations. We won't know where the donors come from, and they could very well spend hundreds of thousands, millions of dollars. If they don't, Claire McCaskill has a great funding advantage, and she also has a little bit of a national Democratic wind at her back. Democrats in other Senate races in other states are moving up, in part because of Mitt Romney's problems. So she has the advantage after the 25th, absent some sort of third-party money.
You keep mentioning the 25th.
Yeah,
to go back for a moment. September 25th is a significant day. That's Tuesday, because that is the last day that he can actually take his name off the ballot,
yes,
and the Republican Party can then pick a replacement legally,
right,
and have someone else run against Claire McCaskill. Now, if, given this latest poll this week, that shows him 4 points up with 2.3% margin of error, is that likely to happen when he is so competitive?
Right, well, let's step back for a second. To think that Karl Rove wouldn't reverse on something that he said and do the exact opposite a couple months later, let's not kid ourselves. They'll do it. The Senate is very important to Republicans. And after that deadline, look, they can use 501c4s and never disclose who gives the money into him. And Crossroads GPS has a ton of cash that they had set aside, and so had the Senate committee to elect Republican senators. They have a ton of money on cash. That money will come back to Akin. The seat is too important for the Republicans to completely walk away. You have to say what you say now and disavow the guy. The money will come back.
Yes. Mary?
It's not about Akin. It is about the U.S.
That's right.
Senate. And he and his mentality, I do not see changing by Tuesday. He's not going to quit.
Okay. Now, it was always said that this was the seat that they needed, the Republicans needed, to win the United States Senate. Is that really still the case? Is this the seat that the Republicans need to win the Senate? Is it?
It's up there. I mean, there are a handful of competitive Senate races, and prior to the comments that Todd Akin made a month and a half ago, this was easily the most winnable. Claire McCaskill was considered the most vulnerable of the Democratic senators. And I think the polling would still, at least to an extent, bear that out, that she is still incredibly vulnerable. And that's why, to Stacey's point and to Dave's point, I think after the 25th, somehow, some way, if these polls continue to hold, the money comes back.
But again, to disagree with my colleagues, Republicans will have some very difficult decisions to make after the 25th, because they are losing margins in Massachusetts, in Wisconsin, in Montana. They're in trouble in Indiana. They have problems in other seats that they expected to pick up, that they want to hold or to gain in order to gain control of the Senate. And if they put money into Missouri against what they promised to do, they will not have the money available for those other races. And they may come to a conclusion that those races are more important to them than Missouri is because of Todd Akin's problems.
Okay, we have a lot of other things to discuss on this program, but I do want to ask, how is this race impacting other regional campaigns? Does it have an impact on other campaigns in our bi-state region?
It does a little bit. For example, I covered a campaign rally yesterday for Teresa Hensley in the 4th District, who's running against Vicky Hartzler, the Republican incumbent. And the first thing that Teresa Hensley talked about was the legitimate rape comment. And I think, or the first question she got, I think, was about that. And so I do think it has some marginal impact, although I don't think it's dominating state politics. But it remains a problem for the GOP brand nationally, because Senate candidates and even the presidential candidates to some degree are suffering a hangover because of the impact of those statements, and they haven't really shaken that completely.
What it has done in the state and in the national elections is it's changed the topic. It's moved it from the economy to social issues, and that plays better for Democrats than what it did Republicans. While we were just talking economy, they walked better in terms of coming into the polls in November. So now that we're talking about things like abortion and other social issues, this is affecting some statewide races.
Mary?
Those issues are always there with a certain segment of the voting population, the conservative issues, the social issues. I think it really did focus on women voters. And how does the GOP look at women? Because when you really drill down in what he said, it wasn't just one offhand comment. It was about a larger ideology that focuses on women, on contraception, on abortion, and that does not play well for the Republicans.
But if I may, to disagree with my colleague, to hold Todd Akin up as the poster child of the Republican Party, I think is a misnomer and is not accurate. But I will say, to Stacey's point about the economy, that's what this election was always supposed to be about, at least for the Republicans. And because of Akin, because of Mitt Romney's 47% comment earlier this week, they have had an incredibly difficult time, and I would argue have done a terrible job staying focused and on track. And ultimately, that could end up hurting them come November if they can't get the conversation reverted back to the